Gracias.
Sí, hola. Hola, hola. Sí, sí. Hey. Oh. Sí, hola. Hola, sí, sí.
Muy buenas tardes. ¿Cómo están? Vean sus padres. Voy a sus padres. Sí, parece que nunca vieron locos en su vida. Los invitados están muy asustados. Más que los locos. Muy bien, sean bienvenidos.
Hasta que la muerte nos separe.
Jessica, te pregunto, ¿recibes a Juan Sebastián como tu esposo? Promete ser fiel en la alegría del dolor, en la salud, en la enfermedad, en la pobreza y en la adversidad, y amarlo todos los días de tu vida. Muy bien. Ya están cansados. Algunos traen unas argollas muy finas, una es de oro amarillo y otra de puro oro blanco. ¿Sí? Las argollas son el signo del amor de Dios que ellos quieren vivir. La argolla es la figura geométrica perfecta. ¿Por qué es perfecta? Porque no tiene principio y no tiene fin. Nos acordamos de la geometría que estudiamos. ¿Sí? Es la figura perfecta, no tiene principio y no tiene fin. Por eso simboliza en el matrimonio el amor perfecto de Dios que ellos proponen a mí. Vamos a bendecirlos en nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Juan Sebastián, te invito a dar a tu esposa esta joya con el signo de tu amor. Esta cualidad de tu esposo Juan Sebastián como signo de tu amor. coração. Por isso a vida está apagada. Se levamos os pés, para que os pés aprendam e olhem por outros jovens que estão em caminho a Santo. Porque já Jessica formou. Então, a tarefa é esta. O projeto que organizamos tenha a outros jovens para que eu tenha uma faixa com os pés para que os apoiem. Juan Sebastián y Jessica llevan este sitio, lo ponen en su hogar, en la sala, y lo prenden para orar. Todos lo prenden cuando hay un cumpleaños, cuando nace un hijo, cuando es un aniversario de la boda, y cuando están peleados también lo prenden. Sea esa luz, Cristo que nos acompañe en el camino de esposos cristianos. Jessica, felicitaciones y siempre adelante. Juan Sebastián, felicitaciones y siempre adelante. El Señor esté con ustedes. ¿Listo?
Thank you. le canto a sus volcanes, a sus praderas y flores, que son como talismanes del amor de mis amores. México lindo y querido, si muero lejos de ti, que digan que estoy dormido y que me traigan aquí. Que digan que estoy dormido y que me traigan aquí. México lindo y querido, si muero lejos de ti. Buscamos un rincón cerca del cielo, si nos dejan, vamos con las nubes del cielo. Y ahí, juntito los dos, cerquita de Dios, será lo que soñamos. Si nos dejan, te llevo de la mano, corazón, y ahí nos vamos. ¡Ya! Si nos dejan, buscamos un rincón cerca del cielo. Si nos dejan, haremos con las nubes del cielo. Y allí, juntitos los dos, cerquita de Dios, será lo que soñamos. Si nos dejan, llevo de la mano, corazón, y allí nos vamos. Si nos dejan, de todo lo demás, que cantara mis canciones y yo cante una docente, sería porque jamás lo traicionaron. Que si alguien opinaba diferente, sería porque jamás lo traicionaron. Me dijo, yo soy uno de los seres que más han soportado los fracasos, y siempre me dejaron las mujeres, no, por favor, llorando y con el alma hecha pedazos. Mas nunca le reprocho mis heridas. Se tiene que sufrir cuando se ama. Las horas más hermosas de mi vida, ¿qué?
Las he pasado al lado de una dama.
Pudiéramos morir en las cantinas y nunca lograríamos olvidarlas. Mujeres, oh mujeres tan divinas, no queda otro camino que adorarlas. Mujeres, oh mujeres tan divinas, no queda otro camino que adorarlas.
Seguro es por desdenes de mujeres, no hay golpe más mortal para los hombres que el llanto y el desprecio de esos seres. Amigo, voy a darte un buen consejo. Si quieres disfrutar de sus placeres, consigue una pistola si es que quieres, o cómprate una daga si prefieres, y vuélvete asesino de mujeres.
¡Algo dice! ¡Un, dos, tres, cuatro! ¡Mátalas! ¡Con una sola dosis de ternura! Asfíxialas con besos y fisura, contágialas de todas tus locuras. Mátalas con flores, con canciones, no les pagues, que no hay una mujer en este mundo que pueda resistirse a los detalles.
¡Díselo!
cantan las columnas serenatas sin ser un día especial.
Is very hard, especially after what the priest said today, that you're leaving your family and they're forming a new family. Okay, but the opportunity that we have had with Isabella and now with Antonia to be present and see you there and know what a beautiful family Jessica has, and know Lourdes and know Rick and know a brother, now David. Hello David, how are you? You're not a myth. You have been the most beautiful family that we could ever expect for my little brother to stay far away from home. It's been a pleasure to know you. It's been an experience to know you, and we are very proud that you are going to take care of what is the most precious thing for my mom, my dad, Isabella, and me. Thank you very much for being there, and I know that you're going to be greater appreciated as we have had until now. Thank you for coming. I hope that you are all ambassadors for Colombia now.
Colombia!
Welcome back whenever you want.
Colombia!
About my time at Grand Valley. We had so many late night study sessions, writing papers for our freshman year classes, and really we just had such a bond of both being completely bilingual, but we didn't believe each other at first that we could both speak English and Spanish, but that's just been such a huge treasure, really, our friendship. And then once we both parted ways and had finished college, any time that I'd go come back through Chicago, Jess always made the time to host me, to show me the city. We had awesome summer times too when we'd come on road trips, and so that's just one of the things that I really appreciated about Jess. A great sense of humor, even though we sometimes have different sense of humor, but it's been something that I've always appreciated about her and our friendship. And although I only met Juan about a month ago, I do trust Jess's judgment in picking Juan to spend the rest of her life with. And I just really want to wish you guys both the best, and know that you can count on me for anything, just like I've always counted on Jess throughout our friendship. Cheers.
Mainly, I just want to thank everybody for being here. That's the main thing. I was told I'm supposed to give a talk, so good news, I've been working on it and I got it pared down to about 3 hours. So that's pretty good. So, noticias buenas, solamente hablo 3 horas más o menos. Now, just mainly want to thank everybody, especially you guys who come such a distance. And we really, I'm sure I can speak for you guys, we really appreciate all the effort to get here. Actually, it might take me 3 hours to get through this, but it's only a couple minutes, so hang with me. Lo siento, no habla español bien. Pero gracias a todos. Muchas gracias. Para los padres, Juan y la familia, todos. Gracias a todos. un país muy muy bonita y la gente es todos más bonita y todos mis familias dicen muchas gracias por todos y muchas gracias por Juan y Jessica por tour guide, tourism, touring stuff. Yeah, on top of everything they've been doing and worrying about, and they showed us around both cities, and we really appreciate that. I don't want to. I would also like to thank the people who aren't here for or couldn't make it for whatever reason, but are here in spirit. There's lots of people that we're very grateful to. I'm thinking of all of our parents and all of our grandparents that have, that are here or not here, and some that have passed on. And, my wife's parents, seniors. So who would have loved to be here? So I think we all should be grateful to our parents and grandparents that have come before us, that if it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be here. And a lot of them had a lot more difficult life than we have. So, Jessica, she's been a joy ever since the first day she was born. That's the best thing she did was she slept through the entire night.
Wow.
The first day, so that's why Ricky and David are here. So. Don't go away yet. She's been a wonderful daughter. She's a wonderful friend to some of you, wonderful niece, Tia, and she's going to be a wonderful spouse also. There are a couple things that she did that made me kind of an Ohio. Just a couple. One is when they were little, I used to drop them off at school. So every time on the way there, I would say, I try to talk slow in case some people want to cambiar idiomas, translate. But when I would drive them to school, I would say, okay, we got one rule here, and the rule is nobody gets smarter than Dad. And I'm glad she violated that, because every time when the little rascals would get out of the car, you know what they would say? I would say, okay, what's our rule?
Don't get smarter than Dad.
No, I didn't know what you said.
What?
Get smarter than Dad. So I'm glad she defied me on that one. The other thing is that cuando tiene dos años, mi español es mejor que ella. Y ahora, no más. Okay, but anyway, I think Jessica and Juan are going to be a great team, and we've probably, most of us, played on teams, and when you're on a team, you have to build each other up, and you try to do your job the best, and I can tell when they're together, they make each other better, and that's what good teams do. So now, you're on the most important team that you're ever going to be on. So I just want to encourage you, and I think I speak for all of us, to make sure you build each other up. Don't tear each other down. Stay together, support each other, comfort each other, honor each other. We both are very hard workers and have a good sense of humor, which you're going to need. And I think it's very important to keep all phases of your life healthy. You try to keep your physical health, your mental health, your psychological health, and you need your spiritual health too, because all of us have times where we ain't got much else than that. So I think you're going to be great together. You're great for each other. And thanks to each of your jobs to try to bring your best self, not just for each other, but you're both going to make the world a better place for all of us. So muchas gracias, and we wish you all the success and fulfillment in the world. Gracias. Gracias. Gracias.
Un aplauso para ellos, por favor.
Sí, para.